Oh, sorry, I was busy trading there, and I wanted to do a video about a new piece of tech that I have. As you know, I love technology, and I'll buy anything that has two batteries in it. And I'll give it a try and see if it can improve my trading. So I wanted to do a video on a new piece of tech that I recently purchased. Please like and comment on the video below. That will allow me to produce better quality videos and more of them in the future. So as you know from previous videos, I've loved doing loads of little bits on tech. I've actually got a great piece of tech to show you, and I keep meaning to do the video on it, and I haven't got round to doing it, and it's hidden behind me. It's been hidden behind me for several videos, not on purpose. It's just you can't quite see it because it's behind my keyboard. Anyhow, I will talk to you about that at some point in the near future, and we will probably give one away for you to win as well. But I wanted to show you something that I bought recently, and I have actually bought this before, because I don't know if you remember a few years ago that I was one of the first people in the UK, rather sadly, to be an owner of the iPad. And recently I went out and bought an iPad Pro. And you're sort of thinking, why do you need another iPad? Well, my old one has died, but also the iPad Pro comes with a pencil. And I don't know why did they call it a pencil instead of a pen? I'm not sure why that is, but anyhow, I digress. The advantage with the iPad Pro is really because it has the pencil. So one of the things that the iPad has lacked before has been a device that's accurate enough for trading. So at one point I did have a Samsung Galaxy because you could plug a mouse into there. And I used that as my backup device. And for when I was traveling, it would be a second monitor as well as a device to kick in if I had a problem with my main PC. But you can see that with the iPad Pro, I mean, it's much faster, the screen quality is much better, but you have the precision of using the pencil, which makes it absolutely epic for trading. So I can just go into here, click on one side, and it will place an order. You can see it was that easy, and it will do it very precisely. So I've just done a little quick scalp on here, and if I want to move this order, I can move it up. Probably the best thing for me to do is to do a close-up so you can actually see this in sort of full screen, as it were. But yeah, let me do that. I will get to the camera and we'll have a closer look at this.
So I've got the iPad Pro on the desk here. You can see I can zoom in and using the gestures and pinch gesture to have a closer look at individual things within the market. But you can see here that there's a lot of information and it looks exactly the same way as you would if you were connecting normally. Apart from what we're doing here is I'm connecting via a VPS. You can see the icons at the bottom of the screen here. So I'm connecting to BetAngel on a remote server, but it's just as fast and as flexible as if you had it natively on here. The advantage is the iPad Pro is really thin, very lightweight and flexible, and obviously quite easy to use. So if I go into here and select a market, I'll select the next market that's coming up. You can see there's the one-click screen. You can see I'm using a combination of gestures and the actual pencil itself. So I could place a bet just by clicking on here if I wanted to. But if we go to the ladder, if I just make that slightly larger, you can go in and place bets the same way you would if you were using a mouse. So I can click over here and put a bet in on one side, click over here and put one on the other. Let me just go a little bit closer on this. And hopefully this order will fill. Come on. Thank you. There's a quick profit. So I could put an order down here, and I can also click and then drag and drop that order the same way as you would do normally. So you can see it's relatively straightforward. It's not complicated to actively trade. I'm trying to hold the mouse here and actively trade, so I apologize if the screen is moving around a little bit. Maybe I should have used a tripod, but then the problem with the tripod is it doesn't sit correctly. So you can see I've got an unmatched bet here. So if I just hold that and pull it down, it will fill at the best available price. Let's have a look here. I've got a net stake of 10 on the lay side, so I need to put one of those in, so I'll put one in there. But you can see it's relatively simple, and the only reason I thought about going for the Pro is my other iPad was getting quite old, and with all of the latest upgrades, I wanted the latest, fastest thing. But primarily it was the pen as well that interested me, because, or the pencil, I should say, because it's much more precise, and that's what you need for trading. If you're using the old iPad, it was a little bit harder to trade with. You could still click on there, and you still can on here. You can see it's quite responsive. But obviously, you know, your fingers get in the way, whereas this is a little bit more precise. Now on BetAngel, you can change the size of the columns here. You can make them bigger, wider, do a variety of different things. So you can modify it to suit and create like a special iPad Pro ladder layout for BetAngel. But I think, you know, I'm just using default settings here. I don't think this is too bad. This is performing pretty reasonably based upon having not modified any elements of it. And you can see I'm successfully trading without really any problems at all. So yeah, that's what BetAngel looks like on the iPad Pro.